Next, you have the 2x2 rib. So first of all, you're going to bring out your needles that you need. I brought out 62 stitches. And you should have gotten this. This is a 2x2 and 2x1 needle pusher. You should have got this with your ribber. If not, you could buy them separately. So now I need to figure out if this is going to work out for a 2x2. So before I put the yarn on, I put the needles back and I see that I'm going to end up with two needles on the knitter and two needles on the ribber. Or if I go backwards, I could go ahead. You need your rack and indicator to pee. So I have, let's see, so I'm going to the ones in the back. So I bring up the end needles on the ribber. Now I could push those back. And I put these needles up to the holding position. Actually, we need to offset these needles a little bit. So what I'm going to do is take the ribber carriage, go across a couple times, so it puts the needles down into work position. And I don't want to do the knitter carriage because it has the yarn in there. But I could go ahead and just push those needles back. Now I need to offset this. So I put the rack and indicator to H. But I go up to where the right needle on the ribber is in between the two knitter needles here. So this way here, my first cast on row, I'm going to be able to hang the ribber comb on. So again, your tension dial's at zero, you knit across, and it makes this funky looking zigzag. Now, this is not wide enough for the 62 needles that I have. So I have to go back to this one here. Pull the wire out, grab the middle of it, and I put the comb up . Put the wire back in. And I have to remember this not being the correct wire. I don't push it in all the way. Then I go ahead and hang my barrel weights. Next, I'm going to do my tubular rows. I did put the tension dial up to 3 this time to see how that does. Of course, you want to fool around. You want to try, see what's going to work for you with the different yarns. Different yarns, different machines are going to give you different results. So I want to knit, because the last stitch is on the ribber, I want to knit on the knitter first. Actually, I have the wrong one set up. So I need the left part button on the knitter pushed in and the right part, right cam set to part so that it'll knit on the knitter first, ribber second. Again, if you're not sure, when you come here, look to see what happens, and it's working just right. And then you're going to set the cams and carriage back to normal. And here, I think, is where I need to put the tension dial up just a tiny bit more. And it's going to do that funky zigzag. Now I need to put the rack and indicator back to P and turn the rack and handle one over, so now it'll do the 2x2. Now you may need to put on your 7 wires on the ends here with a small barrel weight. It's really up to you. Of course, this is where I am going to put my counter down and just start knitting away. And it's going pretty smooth, so I look and I see, yeah, it's doing the 2x2 rib. Now, in the manual, it did have one needle you brought up on the ribber, because the needles were set up differently, and that's, I don't look at the manuals, but I had to go double-check something on that. But I did notice that. Now, for me, I would have had one needle added on the knitter on the end here, and one needle added on the ribber on the right. And then after I finished that, doing the first zigzag row after the two tubular rows, I would take the stitch off of these needles and move them from the ribber to the knitter and the knitter to the ribber. So now I'm all set to keep on going here. I did notice the end stitch did not knit properly. I did get it back on the needle. And then I noticed over here on the right, that's where I need those 7 wires and a barrel weight. But if you don't want to get them, or you don't have them, you could just put your needles up to holding position, as long as you're in the P on the racking indicator, and knit across. Bring those needles back out to hold position. And it feels like the stitch is too tight, and that's probably why it's not knitting properly for me. So I'm going to go ahead, and well, this is just a sample anyways, but I'm going to go ahead and put the tension dial up and see if that fixes it. So yeah, I probably need to have my tension dial in the middle or up above 5 at least for doing the 2x2 rib. The 1x1 rib, I have no problem with this yarn. So this is why you want to double check, try it out with the yarn you're going to use, try the different tension dial settings until you get a comfortable stitch size that you want, and the carriage works good. It doesn't like that. Although I could continue doing that for another 8 rows, say I wanted 20 rows of ribbon, and then I would move the stitches from the ribber to the knitter and then work the rest in stockinette.